President Uhuru Kenyatta's trip to the United Kingdom to attend the London Conference on Somalia, which is scheduled to start tomorrow, has attracted sharp criticism and debate because of his standing and case at the International Criminal Court. The United Kingdom has been criticized for inviting Kenyatta, who is facing charges of crimes against humanity, with the International Criminal Court, with international news channels such as Sky News going to the extent of referring to Uhuru as a criminal president. Justice campaigners in Kenya are calling the invitation of Uhuru Kenyatta to London a betrayal, with Ndungu Wainaina of the Kenya International Center for Policy and Conflict arguing that affording diplomatic courtesies to Uhuru betrays the agenda of the Somali conference to root out impunity and insecurity which lie at the heart of the Somalis' troubles.
When you look at the United Kingdom, when you look at the United States, what may have informed this change is that he is a legitimately elected president of Kenya.
Yeah.
The Kenyan people have decided this is their president.
The United Kingdom had earlier said it would maintain only essential contacts with ICC inductees, but as it stands now, Mr. Kenyatta has been invited to London to attend a conference on the Somalia conflict. The official UK line is based on the United Nations Secretary General Ban Ki-moon's statement that UN member states and staff can initiate contact with ICC inductees who comply with the ICC. Britain's argument is that Kenya is cooperating with the International Criminal Court, and it is right that Kenya should be represented at the Somalia conference based on the kind of work the country has done towards bringing normalcy to Somalia. But behind the scenes, diplomats and intelligence officials from both sides are said to have had high-level talks to secure Uhuru's invitation to London while not sending out mixed messages about the ICC. It follows an election which saw relations between Uhuru's supporters and the UK strained and anti-foreigner sentiments wiped up on a scale not seen since independence.
The interpretation was that they want to impose a leader on us. And unfortunately, as we went, there were only two horses. And your answer is as good as mine, who the perception was they were supporting.
For Uhuru, the fact that he has a troublesome neighbor in Somalia and Kenya being a key player in the global war on terror in the Horn of Africa could be his triumph cards. Kenya provides nearly 5,000 troops to Somalia and is the UK's most important strategic ally in East Africa, so a snub to Kenya's new president was always unlikely. Gideon says that this is a first indication of what is considered to be essential contact with an ICC-indicted leader, a term which is likely to be open to wide interpretation depending on the political circumstances. For JSO 7, I'm Shem Oluchiri.